Oh, God.
Oh, God.
Hey everyone, bit of a silly video today. Basically, when SSDs first started coming out, people used to say they were a lot faster than hard drives, which of course we all know to be true. But the other more secondary benefit of these is that they're apparently a lot more durable than hard drives, because these have circuit boards and a platter that spins round and things like that. And so everyone says these are really fragile. And over the years, I've ended up with loads of different hard drives, and I've kind of decided I want to get rid of them. But first, I'm going to see just how less durable they are. So I tested each drive on my home lab NAS by running it with SATA cables there so I could hot swap things out. I have 7 hard drives, 2 bigger ones and 5 smaller ones, and an SSD thrown in the mix just for science. Before doing any testing at all, I hooked them up to my home lab NAS, booted into Windows and formatted every single disk so I was starting fresh, and then I copied a bunch of files into it so I could refer back to them and make sure the drives were healthy. And then I labelled every single drive up for science. So I thought we'd start off simple and accidentally drop a couple of hard drives off the desk, which is around 84 centimeters or 33 inches. I'm not going to be too scientific in this video, but that's what I'm going to do first. So I've pre-tested all of these drives work, as you've already seen. So if we get this hard drive there and then it just accidentally drops onto the floor. So that was number one, and now we're going to try it with number 6 as well. And my numbers are already rubbing off, but it's okay. So we put that there. That one actually hit the skirting board. Let's see if they work. If they do, we'll then carry on and actually drop things on them as well. But let's see whether these two work. Firstly. Okay, so I've plugged the hard drive into the computer. So let's see if it actually starts up. Yes, it does. Okay, so that still works. That's hard drive number one, so the slightly bigger one, and files load up fine. So no issues there. Let's just check the other one as well. Yeah, so that is disk number 6, and that also loads up fine. It's got whatever this picture is. Yeah, it loads up the pictures, it loads all the files on there. So they both survived a standard drop from a standard desk. So now let's chuck things on top of them. So this is the screwdriver. So that was a direct hit onto the hard drive number 1. And then I'll do the same with hard drive number 6. And I still don't know why I'm doing this video, but here we go. Let's carry on. Yes, that was, I think, a direct hit. I don't know if I hit it, so I'm going to try it again. God, definitely a hit. Yeah, the disc flipped over, so that was definitely a hit as well. I'm just going to check that that works before I drop more stuff on it. Because this is number 6. So that is probably our first failure. Yes. But that is now dead. As you can hear, it makes a weird chirping noise when I actually plug it in to try and turn it on. So, whoops. Oh, please, I don't want to kill 2 just from 1 screwdriver. Please, please, please. Yes, no chirping. No chirping. That's healthy. That's a healthy sound. Right, so there we have it. Good healthy noise. Yes, it shows up, it shows up. That's great. So my slightly bigger one, drive number 1, the 3.5-inch disc, is still working. Right, so this is the disc 1 I've just unplugged after verifying that it works. What I'm going to do is drop a tape measure on it. That might seem like a silly test, but actually this is a lot heavier than the screwdriver, so let's try that as well. So let's put it there. I'm going to drop it from the same height. Ooh, should I drop it with a metal? I don't know. Let's just do a dead weight test first. Okay, so I've dropped it. Let's see if that works. Right, so it's making a healthy noise. Right, so again, that seems to have survived. It made a healthy noise on startup, and then it shows all the files, which again, I can access. So that is pretty good. Right, so this is gonna be with the metal end that you can see here. I'm just gonna drop it and just see whether that changes anything. But if not, I'll move on to the next test, but let's have a look. I hate doing that. It feels really unnatural. Even though I'm going to chuck this out, I'm literally going to chuck it out in a few days, take up the local recycling centre. It still feels unnatural to drop stuff. But let's see whether this has actually survived yet another direct hit, which would be the 3rd or 4th direct hit. Right. So yet again, all of the files have appeared, so it's actually survived a direct hit multiple times. Maybe that means that these older drives are simply less reliable than the other ones, or maybe this was on its way out anyway, but we're gonna do more tests to actually determine that. So that's the very top, and then... So that bounced like a foot or so, but let's see whether that works now. Yeah, that's quite a healthy sound. Okay, so again, we have files. Yeah, so again, it boots up and it shows those files. So it survived that drop as well. What I'm gonna do at this point is actually drop my number 5 drive here and actually from the same height and see whether that survives it. So again, same height, number 5 drive, and... Oh! Okay, so that then slammed into the side of my desk as well. It actually bounced a little bit. They like bouncing, don't they? But basically, let's see whether that starts up now. Okay, so there you have it. Number 5 is also healthy. I'm not gonna look at the files on it. I'm quite happy that it can survive a drop like that. Okay, so at this point, I think it's quite clear that simply dropping things can work quite well from a decent height. Next, I'm gonna ramp things up a little bit by dropping it down the stairs, and I'll hopefully hit hard flooring, and then we can see whether that actually alters things a bit. Right, so it's hard drive time. I'm not sure, how do I throw them down the stairs? I don't know how I'm gonna do this. Okay, let's do it from here, and let's just see what happens. Ah, God!
Oh, God!
Right.
Oh, God! Oh, God!
Okay, and then we're gonna do the 2.5mm one as well. Bit more anticlimactic, let's help that on the way a little bit more. Okay, come on. Right, okay. It's probably... That didn't go too well, did it? Let's try that one again. Brilliant. So we're back in my study now with the 2 drives. It didn't work too well with the smaller one, but it worked very well with the bigger one, probably due to the weight. It didn't kill my phone though, thankfully, even though I could see it just spiraling towards my phone at quite high velocity, but let's actually see if these 2 drives work. So number 1, this is the bigger drive. Oh, I don't like those noises. Yes, I'm pretty certain that one is dead. So that's the bigger drive that spun really fast down the stairs and then hit the solid floor and then whacked into my doorframe. And it's actually left a little dent on the doorframe too. So then there were 5. So let's try the next one, which is the number 5 actually, but I've only got 5 of these drives left. It survived. So that is my smaller hard drive, which obviously it didn't go down quite as well as we've seen. It took less of a force and it did actually survive. So we could see it there, disk D. Right, so my next test is gonna be dropping it my height, which is around 6 foot, from the stairs onto a solid floor. I put a mat down just so I don't mark my floor and my wife doesn't kill me or notice that I'm doing this. But in general, that's gonna be it. So a 6 foot drop, let's see how it goes. Number 5. What I'm also going to do, I forgot to say, is I'm going to try out the solid state drive as well, because everyone says how reliable they are. I did not like those noises. Let's see if this works. It's number 5. It does. Yes. Look at that. So number 5 still works. That is the one that actually fell my height to around 6 foot onto a solid floor, and that still works. You can see all the files there. Let's see if that works. Yes, it does, as expected. So drive 3, all the files are there, which I completely expected because it's an SSD as well, but at least they both survived a fall from 6 foot onto solid flooring. So that is pretty cool. So let's do more stuff. I'm outdoors, which is scary. What I'm gonna do now is actually drop this from this height, so more than my actual height, and I'm just gonna drop it onto solid concrete floor or patio flooring, or whatever you call it. So let's see if that works. I'm gonna drop it from there. It's raining, so I just want to dry that off. Oh, no. Hang on. Just making a clicking noise. That's dead. So that is drive number 5, which I dropped from above my head outside onto some concrete, and that died too. But it did survive being dropped onto solid flooring downstairs, which was protected by a really thin mat. So a lot of these drives have actually survived slightly better than I thought. I thought many of them would break on the very first test, and some of them have been really durable. So this is a new drive, number 4, and I'm going to drop it out of a second story window. As we call it in the UK, it's basically a first floor. You've got the ground floor and then the first floor, or we call it second story for some reason. And I'm going to try and do that, and let's see whether that breaks it. And I'm assuming it will. Okay, that was not a good noise. I'm going to go and get it and dry it off because it's raining, and then once it's dried off, I'll try it out. That's not a nice sound. Oh God, oh, I'm so sorry. It died on me. Oh, I'm so sorry. Okay, so as expected, drive number 4 did not survive being thrown out of a top floor window. So basically, in terms of how many drives we've got left, I've got my solid state drive, which still works. I've got two 2.5-inch drives, which I haven't done anything with, and then also this 3.5-inch drive, which I haven't done anything with. So in that sense, I got 3 hard drives, which I haven't tested yet, and then I got my solid state drive as well. Okay, so I've gone to my garage to get a bunch of other stuff, and what I've also got is some magnets, because if this wasn't enough, I've always been interested in what happens with magnets. I know some people say don't put them onto the drive, but do they mean don't do that when it's not running, or do they mean don't do it when it is running? So I'm going to do both and see, along with just doing a bunch of other stuff. I've got my different drives there. Let's see if that works. So that is making a normal noise, and it has appeared on my actual computer. Okay, so all 4 actually survived a hit from a mallet, which isn't too surprising, but I did give it a decent whack, so it's actually good to test that, I guess. But now we're actually going to try with a metal hammer and see whether that changes anything. Oh, forgive me, Father, for I have hit my drives with a hammer. Oh, God. Right, so let's start out with the 2.5-inch drive. Yes, so that has appeared on my computer, even though it's had a direct hit from a hammer. Okay, so all of my 4 drives actually survived a hammer hit as well, which is quite surprising actually, because they did bounce a little bit when I hit them. And again, I used a decent amount of force, I didn't just lightly tap them or something like that. So what I'm thinking about is, do I actually hit the underside? And I'm thinking yes, but I'm only going to do it with one of them. So I'm going to pick disc number 3 as my sacrificial lamb, and I'm actually going to hit the underside and see whether that changes anything. Oh, that wasn't too bad. Let's see if that works. Okay, so let's put that there. Yeah, it's appeared. It's appeared again, so that works fine. I'm going to hit it more. I know this sounds a bit sadistic, but I'm going to hit it more and see whether that changes anything instead. Ooh, it flipped over. That's a game on Squid Game, isn't it? Can you flip things over? But let's try that now and see whether that works. And it's gone. Yep, no output. So that is number 3, which I hit a lot of times with a hammer. Okay, so I got pretty strong magnets, and then I've got one of my hard drives. I know magnets don't do that much with SSDs, but I was interested to see what they'll actually do with a hard drive, and they are quite strong. So let's gently place it. Thank God. Jumps up, doesn't it? 2 on the bottom. So we'll do something like that. There we are. Okay, so that's that. I don't actually know. I'm going to take the magnets off and then power it on. If it still has data, then I'll put the magnets back on while it's still running. Okay. So that is the 6 magnets, and let's actually see whether it works or not. So at the moment it is showing data on the drive, as you can see, but now I'm going to pop a magnet on it and actually see what happens. Ah! Oh, that noise. So is it a healthy drive, or is that just an old? No. No. This actually died. I've tried accessing a file on it and it's now died, which is entirely expected because obviously I've put it in a way that it can't spin. Oh, I really didn't like that, did it? I'm going to take the magnet off and see whether that changes anything. I'm so sorry. Magnet, come off. Right. It's back. The D drive is back. I can actually access files. That is amazing. So put Mac not on it while it's running, which stopped it working. But then when I took the magnet off and, you know, rebooted everything, it actually worked again. That is crazy. I was going to say I'm not going to test anymore, but yeah, actually, at some point a magnet is going to kill a drive while it's running. So let's put 6 on there and actually see whether that finishes off for good. I'm sorry. 1, 2, 3. Oh, look at that sound. 4. I'm sorry. 5. Oh, no. Oh, I didn't like that. 6. I'm sorry. There we are, 6. So that is what's known in the business as an unhealthy drive. But I'm gonna get all the magnets off. Oh God. Ah. So let's get all the magnets off it. Where's that gone? I can't see it now. That is there, bloody hell. Very strong magnets, very, very strong. Okay. That is a dead drive. So now we have, what do we have left? We got our solid state drive and then we got our normal hard drive as well. So I am gonna drill them, maybe put a nail in them as well. Obviously it's gonna kill them, I know it's gonna kill them. And again, this whole video, these were gonna go up the tip anyway, they were e-waste, I wasn't gonna use them anymore. But yeah, this will be the final death knell of it. Should I drill the edges first? Yeah, I'm gonna drill the edges first and just see whether there's any chance of it surviving if I drill the edge. If I drill the very middle, I'm assuming it's gonna kill it. Yes, yeah, so that's definitely 3 holes. One there, one there, one there. Let's see if it... Oh, it's got some shakiness to it. Let's see if it starts up. Yes, it worked! How? How did that work? Should I just go straight for the middle? It seems like I probably should. Ah, yes, finally, right. Literally hole all the way through it, as you can see. Gone all the way through. It did damp my drill bit though, I think a little bit. It's dulled it a little bit. But there we are, that's a hole clean through. I can actually see myself on the camera now, so I'm assuming this isn't going to work anymore. But let's actually just try it out. So let's do that. That. What? It's loading. No, it cannot load. How has it done that? It's literally still working. D. Yeah, good. How is it working? Maybe I missed a circuit board. I'm gonna have to drill it more. Yeah, that's literally what I'm gonna have to do. I can't believe that. I literally can't believe this done that and still worked. Ah, finally. It's actually genuinely hard work, but the actual housing has started to bend now, so I'm assuming this has killed it. Okay, so power and SATA. 2 holes clean through it. And nothing has appeared, thankfully. It's dead. Which I shouldn't be happy about, but I can't believe I literally drilled 3 holes through it and then it's still powered up. I then drilled a hole through it completely in the middle of it and it still worked, which amazed me. But now it is finally dead. I mean, it's not showing me anything. It's not being added by Windows. So we've got 1 drive left, which is my hard drive, which I'm gonna probably try and put a nail through it. It sounds really sadistic, but let's just see what happens. Right, that is actually quite hard to put a nail in. I'm assuming it's dead. I mean, I've hit it enough times. I mean, I know it survived a hammer blow before, but I'm assuming I've hit it enough times to actually kill it. Okay, so it's got nails sticking through it. Don't have very high hopes for this, but let's have a look. Yeah, that's not healthy, and I don't think it's showing up on the computer. Okay, so that final hard drive isn't showing up either, which is entirely expected because there's a nail sticking out of it, which I couldn't actually pull out, even though I did try. So that kind of sums it up. In conclusion, hard drives are actually more durable than I thought. You can drop them from head height and you can hit them with a hammer and a mallet and do different things. But at some point, they're obviously gonna die. I don't know whether this video was helpful or useful, but hopefully it was entertaining. And if it was, please click the thumbs up button and please subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.